So this verse in Paramatma Sandarbha, number 93, Sri Jiva Goswami, is so beautiful. This summarizes Krishna exactly. Kartum, kartum, akartum, anyata kartum, sa ishvaraha. Sa ishvaraha. Sa ishvara. He, the ishvara, the ishvara. Paramishra Sri Krishna, Ishvara Paramakrishna, Satchidananda Vigraha, Anadi Radhir Govinda, Sarvakarana Karanam, Govindam, Hari Purusham, Tamaham Bhajami, Govindam, Hari Purusham, Tamaham Bhajami, Venam Kavantam Aravindalaya Taksham, Bharavatam Samasitam Buddha Sundarangam Kandarpa Koti Kamaniya Vishesha Shobam Govin Ishvara Paramakrishna Paramishvara Sri Krishna. So here's Sa Ishvara. What is the nature? What is the lakshan? The characteristic? The Vishesh lakshan? The special characteristics of Bhagavan? Of that Ishvara? Sa Ishvara? Kartam akartam anyata kartam. He can do this, or he can do that, or he can do something else. This is this one sutra, which is written by Jiva Goswami Pada. So this is the same as Bhagavatam. For Gaudiya Vaishnavas, the writings of the six Goswamis, Vishnu Chakravarti, Narottam Das, Baladevi, Vibhushan, they are equal to the Shrutis, they are equal to the Upanishads, they are equal to Gita, Bhagavatam. They are same potency, same power, because these are Nitya Parishads. They are the Kayavyuha Shakti of Radharani. They are the direct expansions of Ladini Srupini Radha, Sri Manjari, Sri Goswami, Sri Labanga Manjari, Sanatan Goswami, Sri Raghunath Das Goswami, Tulsi Manjari, Sri Jiva Goswami, Vilas Manjari. They are Radharani's Amsh. They are direct Kayavyuha. Kaya means body. Vyuha means expansion. So what Radharani says is transcendental and true. What Krishna says is transcendental and true in Gita. It is called Aparasheya. Aparasheya means transcendental, beyond this material world, infallible, perfect knowledge. Shruti, Shabda. Same with Goswamis. So here, Kartam, Akartam, Manyata Kartam, Sa Ishvara. Because so this one shloka is the answer to thousands of questions people ask about Krishna. Well, why did Krishna? Here we see that Krishna is on the. It seems to me there's three Krishnas. There's Vrindavan Krishna, the Chor, then there's the Kurukshetra Krishna, the philosopher, and then there's the Rukmini Krishna, the king, the ruler. No, there's one Krishna. I don't understand why Krishna, he dances on the Kaliya, then he said, Krishna can do, or he cannot do, or he can do something else. This is beautiful. My teacher was telling me this the other day. Kartam, akartam, anyata kartam. Why is he doing that? Oh, well, Krishna should, like sometimes people say, oh, Krishna shouldn't do this. Krishna shouldn't lie. No, he can lie or he cannot lie, or he can do something else. He can lie and not lie at the same time. You know, by your Sanskrit, if you break it this way or that way, Saraswati can, you can influence Sanskrit. Agata means not come or not home.
No.
You know, there's different ways. Agata means not there and not home. Like we say, your husband, when we're talking about Rupa Manjari and Vilapkusa Manjari, verse 1, says, oh, Tulsi Manjari is saying, oh, Rupa Manjari, your husband is not at home, Agata. And then, so how you have cuts on your lips? Your husband's out somewhere with the cows, buying cows in Agra or whatever. And last night you come next morning, all bites like some romantic interlude with your husband. And then, or it can mean the husband has not come yet, which means you don't have a
husband.
Like a virgin Kanya. Kanya, you say, oh, Pati Agata? Your husband is not, that means your husband has not come. She's a Kanya. She's not married. She lives at home with her mother. So this is the tikas on this verse in Sanskrit. Vilakrita Manjali, number 1. Das Goswami Pad. Agata. So some people say, oh, no, that Rupa Manjari is married. Some Babaji's, they say. And others say, no, she's not married. It's like this. So this is the beauty of Sanskrit.